I'm Julie, and this week on Quarantine Queens, we are giving you the mom lowdown on Big. Yes, that's right. Movie watching shouldn't be just for the kids. It should be for the whole family. So that's why we're talking 1980s movies, my favorite. We'll be guiding you through the movie watching process with curse word counts, cigarette smoking appearances, violence, boobies, and the sexual innuendos that the 80s loved so, so much. This is the official roadmap to the exact times to fast forward or cover eyes, cough loudly over some questionable language, or do jumping jacks in front of your television. Big. Remember that one? Of course you do. Tom Hanks starred in it. He's America's father. But was he in 1987 when he played the role of Josh, the 13-year-old boy who's a little shorter than average and made a wish to be big? He should have said tall, because that's why he woke up the next morning as a man who moves to the big city, gets a job, a girlfriend, and becomes a man, if you know what I mean. And also way more successful than your average person. Besides Oscar-winning actor Tom Hanks, we've got other 1980s movie favorites like SNL's John Lovitz, love him, John Hurd, Mercedes Rule, and Jared Rushton, the redheaded mischievous kid in all the 80s movies. You'll know him when you see him. I thought this PG-rated movie is perfect for a kid to watch. It's PG, what could go wrong? It's got kids, it's got toys, it's got F.A.O. Schwartz, the amazing toy store in it, and it does have all those things, but it also has some interesting language, some old-fashioned 1980s sexual innuendo, and an intimate relationship between a 30-ish-year-old woman and a 13-year-old man-boy. So, yeah, I don't know, kind of like your typical relationship. The curse words. They come big, no pun intended, and they come small. Goddamn clocks in with the biggest mentions at 4 times in the movie. You'll find it at about 52 minutes and a few at 1 hour and 3 minutes. As you can see, there was a parade of goddams in the one part of the movie. In a close second is the word bitch, which pops up about 2 to 3 times. Again, it's all in one spot near the beginning of the movie at about 19 minutes. Now, if you think maybe you can glaze over the word bitch by saying, kids, they're just talking about female dogs. First, I'm not okay with that. Second, the man saying it is using it in the sentence, kill the bitch, which he says a few times. So since this isn't an important part of the movie, I'd say fast forward it if you're worried. The rest of the curse words are one-timers. We've got bullshit at about 30 minutes, hell and ass at 31, shit at 1 hour and 3 minutes. That sounds like a lot, but it's one time and it's quick. Here's where things get a little bit sticky. Josh's best friend, Billy, the redhead I mentioned earlier, he gets a little upset and lets a fly at 1 hour and 20 minutes and rips an hole at 1 hour and 21. The problem, well, those are pretty strong curses and it's a 13-year-old saying it, but you know what? It was well-deserved. Time and place. Speaking of time and place, smoking takes place a few times during this movie. Remember, it's the 80s. In movies, smoking was a way to show status, coolness, badassery, edginess, stress. In other words, everything. It shows up 6 times in the movie and is mostly done by the female lead, Elizabeth Perkins, who plays Susan. She's a high-level corporate independent woman who dates a 13-year-old boy who looks like a man, not her fault. Anyway, in this case, smoking is primarily used to rep a lady who works a lot in a male-dominated field, which is stressful. Bing! Badass. Bing! Edgy. Bing! Cool. Bing! High status. Bing! Wow! They covered it all just with smoking, which you will see at 20 minutes and again at 42 minutes during breakfast. That just seems wrong. Cig with your sausage. 43 minutes at a work meeting in the office, fire hazard, hello. And at 45 minutes, 50 minutes, and 1 hour and 1 minute. That many times, I think it's called chain smoking. And now for the sexual innuendos. Hold on to your hats, folks. There's so much sexual innuendo that it's an out-uendo. Is that a thing? I shouldn't have said it, I'm sorry. Keep in mind, the humor here is a play on a 13-year-old in the adult world, so it's funny to the adults and potentially traumatizing to the children, if it doesn't go over their heads. Here we go. At 2 minutes, little Billy is doing what 13-year-old boys do, and that is talk about looking down a teacher's shirt, where said teacher isn't wearing a bra, but an undershirt, so he could see all the way down to her flowers. Wait, what, flowers? What are flowers? You mean nipples! Okay, quick break. The 80s are all about inappropriate sex stuff. So yeah, we're explicitly talking about looking down a woman's shirt, but by God, we will not say nipple. Even though men have those, and so do cats, dogs, and baby bottles. From now on, I'm saying flower. Ooh, I need to pluck a hair that's growing around my flower. Too much? Okay, moving on. At about 20 minutes, we've got some hookers, and one is asking if you want some fun tonight, sweet thing. Maybe she means a round of Twister. At 30 minutes, John Lovitz makes his appearance, and oh boy, does he. He points to a woman, who he refers to as girl, and says, "Say hi to her and she's yours. She'll wrap her legs around you so tight you'll be begging for mercy." Whoa, John Lovitz, that's a lot. Pretty sure this is what an innuendo is, and kind of offensive. Now, it's likely that your kid will respond the same way Tom Hanks' character does and just not get it. Finger crossed you don't have to explain that one. Maybe say exercise, thigh master? We then have a boob bra shot that lasts for an entire 4 seconds at 31 minutes. At 48 minutes, Lovitz is me too-ing a woman on the dance floor. Oh yeah. At 56 minutes, there's a reference to spending the night. You know what? Just say it's a sleepover. But that could get weird when your kid is asking other kids at school to spend the night with him. At 1 hour and 7 minutes, Billy wants a dirty mag. If anyone asks, just say he means dusty. And now it's time for the love scene between a grown woman, Susan, and a 13-year-old boy, Josh, who is in the body of a 30-year-old man. That calls for a whole other conversation, even with yourself. In this scene, starting at 1 hour and 12 minutes, there's kissing, the open mouth kind, which leads to a long shirt unbuttoning scene at 1 hour and 13 minutes. And when I say long, I mean it. It takes like a whole minute. It ends with a lacy bra. It doesn't stop there. From 1 minute and 13 to 1 minute 14, there's quite a bit of boob exploration and long kissing, as we call it in the 80s, while the boob exploration is happening. Let's just say lots of boob exploration. And that's your sexual innuendos. Is there violence, you ask? Not really. There's some gunshots and screams at 22 minutes and at 34 minutes. It's just to show how bad and scary New York City is. Well, that's it. Big is a great movie, and you will love it, and so will your kids. But there are a lot of questionable parts to keep in mind, depending on your kid's age and your tolerance. Common Sense Media says 13 plus, parents are saying 11 plus, and so are the kids. Finally, some agreement. Honestly, the most offensive part, Susan's giant shoulder pads. Ugh, 80s fashion. Before I go, remember to hit the subscribe button below, give us a like, and share our videos. Come back for some more reviews with Quarantine Queens. I'm Julie, and I'm out. Like an innuendo. That's a callback. I shouldn't have said that. It's not even funny. I'm sorry.